Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's learn about C13 NMR spectroscopy by looking at the main features of proton NMR spectra and how they are related to the features of a C13 spectrum. When I think of signals in a proton NMR spectrum, there are normally three key features that I consider: chemical shift, integration, and multiplicity. Let's go through each of these qualities with respect to proton NMR spectroscopy of the H1 nucleus, and then discuss how the quality is relevant to C13 spectra, spectroscopy of the C13 nucleus. For chemical shift, the spectral window for a typical proton NMR spectrum is maybe 0 to 13 ppm. For example, hydrogens off of a benzene ring are often in the range of 7 to 8 ppm. Peaks in a C13 spectrum are also referenced based on their chemical shift, although the spectral window for a C13 spectrum is much wider. A typical C13 spectrum might have a chemical shift range from 0 to 220 ppm. Next up is integration. In a proton spectrum, integration is very useful as the intensity of the peak, red is the area under the NMR peak, is proportional to the number of hydrogens that are causing that signal at that chemical shift. So in a proton spectrum, a bigger signal indicates more hydrogens and a smaller signal indicates fewer hydrogens. In other words, yes, integration is a useful idea in a proton spectrum. C13 spectra are very rarely integrated in the same way as a proton spectrum. All carbon nuclei do not uniformly generate the same signal intensity. In other words, in a typical C13 spectrum acquisition, one carbon may have a bigger peak than another carbon. So, you can't quantify the number of carbons in a signal based on the area under the NMR peak. That's not terrible, but it is a key difference between proton and C13 spectra. Finally, let's consider multiplicity. In a proton spectrum, peaks have characteristics, shapes, and patterns. Singlet, doublet, triplet, etc., that are useful for understanding how many neighboring hydrogens are present. The multiplicity of peaks provides much valuable connectivity information in a proton spectrum. How about a C13 spectrum? No multiplicity. All signals are singlets. While this is not completely true, most C13 NMR spectra are acquired in a manner that suppresses any peak multiplicity. Again, this is not a terrible loss, and the lack of multiplicity is not a huge limitation for C13 spectroscopy. So as you can see from these three features, proton NMR and C13 NMR are not the same. Yes, there are similarities, but there are also differences. I will note that many students feel it is relatively easy to jump from proton NMR to C13 NMR because C13 NMR does have fewer features to interpret since integration, and especially multiplicity, are not part of the discussion. So that was a quick review of how chemical shift, integration, and multiplicity are relevant, or not, for proton and C13 NMR. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and consider subscribing. Questions, comments, feedback, please use the comments section. Take care.